Hello friends, this is Durga again, and as part of Windows for IT professionals to improve their productivity and also set up foundation to explore newer technologies, I have started this playlist. And as you are aware, we have created a set up Sigwins and we have created VM, and then we have actually installed a few softwares which will be useful for future purposes on the template VM. So in this small video, I will cover this important topic called installing Nano Editor, because after creating, after cloning new VMs from the existing VM, we have to set up network on all the VMs. That's the only thing which you need to take care of. And for that, using VI Editor might not be very friendly to you. And also you might not be able to use UltraEdit to connect remotely and modify using UltraEdit. And you will not be able to connect to that using Sigwin also, to the new VMs using Sigwin as well. So Nano Editor is will be easier for Windows users because it understands delete command, backspace command, arrow commands, and all those things. Whereas VI Editor is for Linux-based users, Linux or Unix-based users, and Windows guys might not be very comfortable with that. So without wasting time, let us see how to set up Nano. It's pretty easy. You just have to use Yum installer, and you have to log into the template, and then run command called m-y install Nano. And it will connect to the online repositories, and it will set up Nano for you. So now it is ready. Now you can actually run Nano command, and you can type easily, use backspace to delete, and except saving and all is a little bit different. You have to use control and whatever command you want, which is displayed at the bottom. To exit, you can just say control X. And if it will ask you whether to save or not. In this case, I don't want to save, so hit N. If you want to open a file using Nano Editor, you just have to give Nano and give the file name. And then it will be, whatever you typed will be written to the file. And when you save, the stuff will be persisted. That being said, this is it. It's a very small video. Just to append to this establish internet connectivity and install softwares on CentOS, I am creating this video, and you will see the real value of this Nano Editor when we actually clone it and try setting up network. If you are not familiar with VI Editor, Nano is the better option than VI just to set up the network. After that, there are many ways you can connect to the host and open the files and modify them and save them without struggling with VI Editor. Thank you. Bye.